Well, that was a busy morning of Apple product announcements. Yeah. I will tell you that. My fingers, they're sore from all the typing.
Numb from the typing?
All the typing and all the product announcements.
So they announced a lot more than just the iPad mini, though.
Yes, Apple said they had a little more to show us, and they had a lot more to show us, actually.
Yeah, obsoleted this thing.
Yes, your poor third-generation iPad.
I just got this.
It's no longer the new iPad,
no,
as Apple would call it. People like myself who promised our wives that we were going to get an iPad and then forgot to get it, now we look like crafty shoppers
crafty
at last.
Crafty consumers, right. Yes. Yeah. So they also introduced the 7, or the 7.9.
Right.
More like an 8-inch.
The iPad mini, yeah.
Yeah.
For the marquee announcement that everyone was expecting a little bit, I will be honest, a little bit...
A little lame. A little lame. You can say it's a little lame. I'm surprised it's $329.
Yeah, the price point, I think, is something that took a lot of people by surprise. I think...
It's huge.
Many people were expecting maybe $75 cheaper, $250.
I thought $250
more
for sure.
Competitive with the likes of your Kindle Fires and your
Kindle Fire,
your Nexus 7s. Right.
They're all $199. Right. Is the entry point for those things, and for 16 gigs as well. So it's not like they're giving you more. Apple made a big deal about how it's a much nicer tablet, and I'm sure that'll be fine. And I'm sure they'll sell a whole bunch of these because hey, it's a cheaper iPad. Mm-hmm. It's definitely a cheaper iPad, and people want cheaper iPads.
Our friend and colleague. Chris Breen drew the comparison to the iPod Nano, which was, when it was first introduced, a little bit pricey.
At $250, Apple would have sold, Apple would have stopped people from buying Kindle Fires and Nexus 7s. At $329, I don't think they do. I think a $200 tablet versus a $329 tablet, I think people still are going to buy... 5 million Kindle Fire HDs.
It depends. For the people that are shopping on price, they will sell that. I think Apple, after a dozen years of covering this company, they really don't do the race to the bottom on pricing.
They have
their price point and they have their market of people who want to pay that price point.
I expected they were going to come in $50 more, be more expensive, but $50 more expensive, where you'd go, I'll pay a little more for the better thing.
Sure.
So also where they kind of jacked up the prices on the new iMac, which the old iMac started at $1,100 or $1,199, I think, and the new one's $100 more, the entry level, right? But it's a new iMac. It's thin.
Totally new, very thin. In fact, in many ways, it's like Apple held an iPad product announcement and then a Mac product release broke out.
It is.
The iMac to me was the most eye-catching of the announcements because my goodness, that iMac looks like it needs to eat a sandwich or two. In a way, for the viewer at home might look and say, here is the old iMac, sort of pleasingly plump, but, getting a little long in the tooth, hadn't been updated since May 2011. Here's the new thin iMac. Look at that.
I want to say it's
44% thinner, 8 pounds lighter, my goodness.
Well, all right, so 44% on the edge.
Yeah.
It really balloons up in the middle.
Well,
the back,
because you have to get the you have to get those gonna, parts in there somewhere.
But they have good parts. It's a full Ivy Bridge Core i7s, Kepler NVIDIA GPUs, GeForce 640s, which would play any modern game. So they didn't leave out those Mac gamers, which I was worried that they did.
Mm-hmm.
They did leave out those Mac gamers on the new MacBook. I was really disappointed by that. The 13-inch MacBook. Thinner Retina display, which is totally awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Lighter, better ports and connections on the side. Got rid of the optical drive, but they also got rid of the discrete GPU, which means it's a shame. I just thought it was a shame to have this super high-res screen and then to drive it off Intel integrated graphics. It seems like
I think it's Apple filling out its product line. Apple does the thing where they introduce a new technology. Hey, here's our 15-inch MacBook Pro. And then they slowly build it out and bring up the specs. And this is the latest in the journey of 1,000 steps with with its laptop lineup. Of course, Mac Mini, also introduced today. Not as eye-catching, looks the same, except for the USB 3.0 ports, and if you can
spot... A lot of them, four of them, yeah.
Yeah, four of them.
That back of that thing is just loaded with ports.
Yes, but otherwise looks about the same as your older version. The true beauty lies within, as so many things in life, with the faster Core i5 and... Core i7 processor for
more storage,
for the more expensive one.
I think that product, when Intel releases new chips next year,
that version of that product is going to be a killer home theater PC. The much more powerful graphics coming in Intel's next generation of chips, and when you stuff those in a little $600 box, that's going to be awesome.
Sure.
I'd love buying one of those.
And of course, new versions of iBooks and iBooks Author, as all of us were surely anticipating and hoping for. Well, really busy day, lots to cover, lots to get back to. Yeah. I got to get back to work. I will catch you on the flip side.
All right. And this is basically worthless now.
Yoink.